Sami Special Orchard 60 and 75 tractors. The design of the new Sami special tractors for orchards, vineyards and olive groves is the fruit of the most careful research into satisfying the numerous requirements of specialist modern agriculture. Compactness. The absence of projections and protrusions and the restricted overall size of the new Sami orchards 60 and 75 are essential features, enabling them to move rapidly between the crops without damaging them. High maneuverability. The extremely small turning radii, achieved due to the 50 degree steering angle, are essential in order to reduce handling time and also so as to take advantage of the last square meter of growing land. High productivity. The powerful engines, 60 and 75 horsepower, the large capacity of the lift unit, and the high power of the hydraulic system enable working times to be reduced by the use of much bigger implements. Operating economy. Very low consumption figures, reliability, and simplicity of servicing mean that the tractor heading has minimum incidence in production costs. Great comfort. Absolutely essential to eliminate driver stress and, when necessary, protect him from weather conditions. But for Sami, it does represent a link of primary importance in the chain of productivity. Finally, even on the special tractors, a clean driving cab, designed according to the most modern criteria for habitation, aesthetics and comfort, as appeal to the car-owning public. Wide, spacious running boards, suspended pedals, and plenty of vital space to greatly facilitate climbing in and out, as well as handling precision. All the controls are arranged according to the new ergonomic criteria and are in a well-protected position so as to prevent them from becoming entangled with branches or fruit. The levers are covered with a soft material, and the gearbox levers have smart protective covers. The dashboard is well endowed with instruments of modern design and easy to read. The seat, which is adjustable fore and aft and in height, as well as for suspension, reduces driver stress and allows minimum seat heights from the ground to be achieved. Only 890 millimeters on the 60 horsepower and 920 millimeters on the 75 horsepower, thus drastically reducing the overall man tractor volume. The telescopic steering wheel, which is adjustable for height, can be lowered down to 1240 millimeters on the 60 horsepower and 1270 millimeters on the 75 horsepower, and does not hinder the operator from bending down during work between the crops with the wheel lowered, and enables him to adopt a more suitable driving attitude on roads, wheel raised. The ease of threading one's way beneath the branches is enhanced by the lack of any sharp edges or protrusions on the mudguards and engine bonnet, which, as it is low slung, is only 1,147 millimeters from the ground in the 60 horsepower model and 1,172 millimeters for the 75 horsepower. All the control levers are arranged in protected positions so as to prevent any possibility of them becoming entangled in branches or fruit. To this end, other solutions have also been adopted, such as the groove in the dashboard for the direction indicators levers and the hand accelerator and the use of rotary circular switches as well as flick switches. Mudguards adjustable to three height positions depending on the size of the wheels, fitted with rubber side flaps, prevent any possibility of damaging the fruit. Thank you. The transverse dimensions, with a minimum width of 1,320 millimetres for the 60 horsepower model and 1,370 millimetres for the 75 horsepower, are also suitable for old planting formats, where the width between the rows is very narrow. Safety, in the event of overturning, is guaranteed by a roll bar conforming to EEC standards, which does not project beyond the bonnet when it is lowered forward. Same, who have always specialised in air-cooled diesel engines, have equipped their special 60 horsepower and 75 horsepower orchard tractors with the new series 1000 engine, which offer the best to be expected in terms of performance, consumption, reliability, and simplicity of servicing. Their exceptional performance figures are expressed by the extremely low specific consumption figures, 166 to 171 grams per horsepower hour, high resilience with up to 26% reserve torque, and high power, even at low engine speeds. 70% of maximum power is generated at 1,500 RPM. Such performance is the result of the most advanced technological solutions. Triple cooling system. By forced air circulation for cooling the top parts of the cylinders and the heads. By oil circulation in suitable cavities made in the cylinder block for cooling the bottom of the cylinders. A thermostatic valve ensures that the oil does not pass through the appropriate cooler at low engine temperatures, thus accelerating the heating process of the engine itself when starting up from cold. By a pressurized oil jet below the cylinders, giving greater reliability even under the heaviest usage. Greater uniformity of cooling of the cylinders, guaranteeing their perfect cylindrical shape. Improved tightness between pistons and cylinders for better engine output. The cooling systems of these engines include some other interesting features, such as new geometry of the cylinder fins, providing a greater surface in the zone where the greatest heat is generated. Cooling fan with rear stator to give a better cooling efficiency and less power absorption by the fan. Soundproofed air conveyor to give better sound attenuation. Spiral induction manifold. The eddying movement imparted to the air on input into the cylinders facilitates optimum blending with the fuel, with the benefit of lower consumption and less emission. Advanced injection system. Fed via individual pumps immersed in the cylinder block, directly controlled by the camshaft, with injection pipes all of equal short length, optimizes the effectiveness and uniformity of injection and the quality of the combustion. The result is lively operation and extremely low consumption. The use of individual, identical, independent pumps increases reliability and simplifies servicing. Integral lubrication. The lubricating oil runs in channels worked in the cylinder block and in the control rods of the rocker arms. This has the advantage of reducing the weight of the engine components and eliminating any possibility of leaks. Even under the heaviest prolonged usage, reliability is guaranteed by the oil cooling circuit. Modularity. This is one of the fundamental concepts of the design of the new 1000 series engines. Independent cylinder heads, individual pumps with identical injection pipes, split-bodied regulator, etc. Any attendance, therefore, is easier, rapid, and costs less. Robustness. The tall cylinder block and housing of cast iron mean that our engines are all self-supporting, which fulfills the structural tasks and do not require the use of longitudinal members, which would reduce the maneuverability of the tractor. The use of the special tractors requires very low speeds when working in orchards, vineyards and olive groves, and then speedy road running for cartage or ferrying. Of vital importance for this is to have a suitable number and ideal distribution of gear speeds. The new Sami Orchard 60 and 75 already have in their basic configuration 12 forward speeds plus 12 reverse speeds, one of which is only 900 meters per hour at maximum power output in the slowest gear. In the configuration with super reduction gears, 16 forward speeds and 16 reverse, this drops to only 300 meters an hour. The low starting speed in first gear, 8 kilometers per hour, allows for easy starting off with trailers in tow, even on a climb. The gearbox is fitted with a gear speed inverter, thanks to which all the forward gear speeds are available in reverse, which is indispensable for reducing maneuvering times when working on hills, in between rows, and within the farmyard. Work in orchards and vineyards requires the use of a wide variety of implements, which need mechanical power on the part of the tractor. These range from automatic mixers to cutters, fertilizer spreaders to stone pickers, from harvesting machines with driven axles to trash shredders. The different power loads required from these implements impose on the tractor the need to be equipped with a very reliable and very versatile power takeoff, capable of all the speeds necessary to operate any implement, whatever, so as to guarantee maximum productivity. The two speeds of 540 and 1000 RPM permit all the various power requirements to be met for the different tasks, and these are obtained at engine speeds, which allow the best advantage to be taken of the engine power whilst maintaining a good torque reserve. The 1000 RPM in particular are obtained at 95% of maximum power output of the engine, so as to be able to have maximum power available for the most arduous tasks. The 540 RPM are obtained at 88% of maximum power output, which is an ideal setting to be able to maintain low consumption for lighter tasks. The power takeoff is engaged by means of a lever, completely independent of the gearbox clutch, so as not to interfere with the rest of the transmission, whether the tractor is motionless or moving, or even under load. Fruit, grapes, olives, etc. are often cultivated on hillsides, where the use of trailers and implements with driven axles is more frequently required. To meet these requirements, these models have been fitted also with a power takeoff synchronized with the wheels. This type of PTO is equipped with two reduction ratios, which allow for the use of any kind of trailer, irrespective of the size of its wheels. Disc brakes are used with friction linings of graphite-based sintered material, which is the most suitable material for fulfilling the requirements of high friction coefficient, high temperature resistance, long life, silent operation. The discs are oil bath cool, so that they are preserved from wear and overheating, and guarantee reliability and safety even in the most arduous uses. such as towing heavy trailers down hills, or in manoeuvring, which in orchards where planting is irregular requires continuous use of the brakes to reduce the turning area and so as to be able to move between the trees even when arranged very close together. The final epicyclic reduction gears give greater robustness because the load on the axles is distributed over three gearings and not over a single one, as in the case of cascade reduction gearing. The special tasks in orchards, vineyards and olive groves represent one of the most typical cases in which it is indispensable to have four-wheel drive, since such cultivation is frequently done on steeply sloping ground. The availability of four-wheel drive tractors, which are compact, stable and highly manoeuvrable, means that the use of crawlers can be avoided, as these are very difficult to use for road transport. In responding to these requirements, the characteristics of the Same four-wheel drive models are shown to be insuperable. Ideal weight distribution. About 40% of the weight is over the front axle. This gives high stability and good ground holding. Direct transmission shaft. The absence of joints ensures a high mechanical output, which is translated into total power transmission. Small-sized central differential. This gives the tractor high ground clearance. 285 mm for the 60 horsepower and 300 mm for the 75 horsepower. Locking of the front differential can be engaged simultaneously with the rear differential, prevents dangerous skidding. 50-degree steering angle. The turning radii are extremely small, 3,500 mm for the 60 horsepower and 3,700 mm for the 75 horsepower. These drop respectively to 2,800 and 3,000 mm with the help of the brakes. The productivity of a special tractor for orchards, vineyards and olive groves is strictly bound up with the possibility of fitting large-sized implements to reduce the number of passes, the speed of control and of lifting the implements mounted, the possibility of using large implements with hydraulic action or control, grape gatherers, pruners, front loaders, grinders, etc. For this reason, it is essential that the tractor is equipped with a powerful hydraulic system. The new Orchard 60 and 75 provide for the possibility of using simultaneously the hydraulic lift and the distributors. This feature is essential for the use of the new hydraulically controlled implements mounted on the three-point hitch. The hydraulic lift has a high capacity, capable of lifting up to 2,800 kilograms at the ball coupling, and is equipped with position, draft and combined position draft control, thus enabling high rates of work to be achieved. The open center hydraulic circuit with 2, 4, 6-way distributors and a capacity of 35 liters per minute, which can be extended up to 50 liters per minute by means of an auxiliary pump to order, makes the operation of implements with a high hydraulic power absorption possible. The Category 2A 3-point hitch unit is fitted with telescopic stabilizers for easy correct coupling of the implements. One novelty in the world of tractors is hydrostatic steering, supplied via a priority valve, which means that oil is taken from the lift circuit only when required by the hydrostatic steering in the requisite quantity. Otherwise, the entire oil capacity remains available for the lift unit and the auxiliary distributors. The new Orchard 60 and 75 models are specialists in their sector, but they do not lack great versatility. The maximum speed of more than 30 kilometers an hour and the low starting off speed make the new Orchard models ideal for rapid road transport, even on steep climbs. The wheel tracks, varying from 996 millimeters to 1,276 millimeters on the 60 horsepower and 1,322 millimeters for the 75 horsepower, mean that the new Orchard 60 and 75 models are ideal for working between roads, just as for open field working, thus meeting the demands of those farms with very diversified crops. Many tasks in orchards, vineyards and olive groves expose the driver to toxic substances, such as pesticide dressings. Therefore, to order, the tractor may be fitted out with an original design of safety cap, easily removable whenever working conditions so require. Pressurization and air intake filtering, an active carbon filter is also available on request, effectively protect the operator during crop treatment. Total glazing of doors and windows, as well as the front and rear windscreen wipers, ensure complete all-round visibility in all working conditions. Habitability is optimal. The cab is fitted with a heater for the winter, whilst in the summer, the tinted glazing and the possibility of having on request an air conditioning unit enable work to be carried out in comfort, even in high outside temperatures. In addition, windows, doors, hatch and windscreen can easily be removed. The internal sound-absorbing coverings keep the noise level well below 90 decibels. Italian style. The bodywork has been designed to the new Same style, with pleasing modern lines and well-distributed, balanced proportions. Same is thus proposing to be in the vanguard, even in its attention to the finishing and aesthetics of the tractor. Heavy ground cultivation. Heavy ground cultivation is of prime importance in agriculture for the decisive influence which it has on the resulting harvest and for the costs involved due to the high power which has to be used. Deep ploughing 45 to 60 centimeters constitutes the main cultivation task and is essential in order to prepare the ground for those crops, such as maize and beetroot, which promote extensive root development so as to benefit to a greater extent from the reserves of water and nutrients. It is furthermore essential in order to restore the land or plant new crops. Semi-deep ploughing, 20 to 30 centimeters, is suitable on the other hand for crops such as wheat, barley or oats, which have a more restricted root growth. In all cases, ploughing completely breaks up and turns over the ground to allow the roots to penetrate, to ventilate the ground and form air pockets, porosity, to allow the penetration, circulation, and formation of reserves of water. The improved drainage obtained by ploughing also means that the water can drain down to the deeper strata when it rains, so preventing suffocation of the roots, and then rise to the upper levels again to feed the crops during dry spells. Furthermore, by the action of turning the ground, ploughing enables both organic fertilizers and weeds to be buried, thereby improving fertility in heavy ground. Ploughing is generally done by keeping the wheels on one side of the tractor in the furrow. This is the simplest technique because it does not require strict directional control by the driver, since the furrow forms a track, so to speak, for the tractor. The technique of ploughing with all four wheels outside the furrow is certainly more demanding, but does offer important advantages, such as not compacting the base of the furrow already ploughed, and providing greater ground holding. Since the tractor is on the level, weight is evenly distributed and all the wheels are operating in optimum traction conditions. Heavy ploughing represents for the farmer the point of no return for obtaining a quality harvest. The other side of the coin is, however, the high cost of such ploughing, which takes a long time to do and a high use of power. To improve the ratio between cost and results, dual-level ploughing is becoming ever more widespread, which allows for time and fuel savings which can mount up to 25%. What is being done is a first pass with rippers or subsoilers with one or more tines, capable of splitting open the ground in depth to about 80 or 100 centimetres to benefit root penetration and water circulation. In this last respect, sometimes so-called mole drainers are used, fitted with a towed cylindrical device able to create at depth a drainage tunnel by joining up to the gutters. Subsequent ploughing is done to a modest depth, 25 to 30 centimetres, with multi-furrow ploughs, thus drastically reducing the time and the tractive effort required, since the ground being worked is already partly tilled. The heavy ploughing, amongst which is also included ground levelling done with a scraper or laser levels, requiring very high tractive effort, constitutes one of the tasks which most directly put to the test the quality of the overall design tractors and all their systems. Let us look, therefore, at what is demanded of the tractor in order to carry out, with quality and high productivity, heavy ground cultivation, and how Sámi has responded to these requirements. Above all, good ground adhesion is essential. In order to benefit from the total weight of the tractor, the ideal solution is integral traction, which we have achieved by technological solutions which minimize dissipation so as to obtain total power transmission. A joint-free central shaft, which takes the motive force directly from the gearbox and transmits the torque to the front wheels. By creating tractors with a low center of gravity in a forward position, we have succeeded in guaranteeing correct weight distribution over all the wheels, whether in the furrow, in deep ploughing, or on steeply sloping ground. The adoption of large diameter, wide tread front wheels enables our tractors to generate very high tractive effort with very little compacting of the ground. Furthermore, simultaneous locking of the differentials, both front and rear, prevents wheel spin to the benefit of greater productivity and an improved quality of work. Ground adhesion may be diminished by reduced steering sensitivity and by insufficient speed of reaction by the hydraulic lift in varying the working depth of the implement with the variations in resistance offered by the ground. A high-performance lift is therefore essential. For this reason, we have given the utmost care to the design of our hydraulic lift, the famous Sámi Automatic Control Unit. Above all, instead of on the third point, tractive effort signals are transmitted through the lower arms, where the draft is more intense, as too are its variations, which can therefore react with greater sensitivity so as to guarantee an immediate correction of the depth and eliminate wheel spin conditions. Same's original patented system, instead of using flexural or torsional bars, uses a direct connection by means of a single lever between the sensing unit of the lift and the lower arms. It is very simple, reliable, and retains its precision and sensitivity unaltered by time. The combined position and draft control enables our tractors to do quality work on ground of very variable consistency by preventing the implement from overreacting and by limiting excessive working depth, which could bring to the surface soil which is poor in organic matter. The open center hydraulic circuit adopted for our tractors keeps the oil constantly circulating at a very low pressure and therefore absorbs very little power. When the lift starts operating, the pressure instantly rises to the desired level for the working conditions. As the oil is always circulating, the speed of reaction of the SAME automatic control unit is optimum, since there is no dead starting time. The hydraulic circuit on our tractors is equipped with a load sensing valve, which is sensitive to the working load and makes the oil circulate not at maximum calibrated pressure, but at the level required by the work from one moment to the next. This results in a low power usage commensurate with the draft required, thus enabling the full power of the engine to be used to provide the drive torque to the wheels. The open center circuit has permitted the use of large capacity pumps, 36 to 40 liters per minute on tractors in the medium range, 64 liters per minute on those in the high range. This gives a high speed lift to the implements and for turning the plow. The generous lifting capacity, which compared with the minimum recommended values of the ISO standard, is some 45 to 90% higher on the standard equipment and 100 to 160% when fitted with auxiliary rams, allows the use of long heavy implements such as multi-furrow plows, thereby reducing the number of passes, working time, and ground compaction. Up to four double-acting hydraulic distributors with rapid engagement allow for the adjustment and operation of even highly sophisticated implements from the driving seat. Speed distribution plays a leading role in the accomplishment of agricultural cultivation. Our tractors have a great number of speeds, 20 to 24, with a close ratio evenly distributed. For example, our gearbox has 24 forward speeds with synchronized mini reduction gears in the speed range from 4.5 to 7.5 kilometers per hour, which are those most used for plowing. It also has five speeds according to which work can be done at maximum output depending on the working conditions. Furthermore, the maximum speed of 40 kilometers per hour of our 20 forward speed gearbox in the medium range allows for fast cartage with the benefit of greater productivity. On the other hand, ditching work with rotary ditchers requires very low speeds of the order of a few hundred meters per hour. Our tractors have super reduced speeds, which allow work to be done at only 400 meters per hour at maximum power output. Engine performances directly reflect on productivity and operating costs. Above all, it is essential to have operating resilience. Our engines have torque reserves which amply exceed 15%, extending up to 28%, and a wide, stable range of operation, from 1100 to 1400 to 2200 to 2500 RPM. This results in the easy automatic surmounting of any overloads without having to change down. Heavy ploughing falls under those jobs in which the engine is called on to generate maximum power continuously. The fuel consumption heading then becomes all the more important for the purposes of economic operation and of working range. Thanks to turbocharging, plus an extremely advanced injection system and high turbulence induction pipes, which give an optimum mix of the fuel and air, specific consumption at low power of our engines is in every case below 170 grams per horsepower hour, with some points below 160 grams. For carrying out continuous work at maximum output power, reliability of operation is also very important. A dual cooling system with forced air circulation and pressurized oil spray below the cylinders, together with a lubricating oil cooling circuit, enables work to be carried out in full security at maximum load for prolonged periods. The careful design of the engine has meant that it can be self-bearing without penalizing one of the fundamental requirements for work in the field, maneuverability. Although the front wheels are of large size, they will steer at 50 degrees, and the tractor has a turning radius of less than 5 meters for the medium range and of about 5.5 meters if it is in the high range. We are alone in offering independent brakes on the front wheels too, thanks to which turning with independent braking can be done within turning radii which drop to absolutely record figures, typical of two-wheel drive tractors, 2.90 meters for the medium range and less than 3.5 meters for the high range. In any case, the availability of the gear speed inverter, offering the same running speeds in reverse operation, permits rapid turnabout on headlands and a minimum loss of time on empty return journeys. On medium range tractors, with the inverter being synchronized, they can pass from forward speed to reverse speed and vice versa without having to stop the tractor. For deep ploughing between furrows, it is essential to have high ground clearance, which on our tractors, all designed with four drive wheels, is a basic design feature achieved by means of the use of a small size central differential and the use of large diameter wheels. During heavy ploughing, the tractor is subjected to violent stresses, which put to an extremely hard test not only the transmission units, but also the whole mechanical structure. Robustness is certainly not lacking on our tractors. The front axle is solid cast iron. The engine, gearbox housing and rear axle are designed to form the bearing beam of the tractor. That is an absolutely robust, rigid structure capable of withstanding the greatest strains. Functional capacity allows idle time to be reduced. The cab, with its reopening hatch and the automatic three-point hitch, enable implements to be coupled or attention given directly from the driving seat. Furthermore, having the tank located under the platform facilitates constant supervision of the implement by the driver. Wide doors, even at the bottom, broad steps and easy grip handholds in instinctive positions make frequent climbing in and out of the tractor that much quicker. On very viscous ground in a number of geographical areas, power harrows are used, which guarantee good fragmenting of the ground and do not leave a slough pan. These implements require a high output at the power takeoff, PTO, obtained by means of an adequate ratio between the engine revs and those of the PTO. On our tractors, 1000 RPM can be reached at the PTO at 95 to 99% of maximum engine output, so as to be able to exploit the highest availability of power necessary for this type of cultivation. The hydraulic servo control of the PTO clutch engagement eliminates any effort on the part of the driver, and the oil-cooled multi-disc clutch permits the transmission of very high torques for prolonged periods without any wear or overheating. Heavy ploughing requires the driver to remain on the tractor for extended periods, often in torrid climatic conditions, dusty atmospheres, and on bumpy ground. We offer tractors with a flat platform, suspended on shock-absorbing mountings, equipped with a padded adjustable driving seat, and with cab heating or ventilation. Ensuring the driver's comfort allows him to work attentively, for long hours, so as to obtain the best quality of work. Same tractors offer still more for heavy ground cultivation. In fact, the possibility of providing, in the robotic system, a front lift and PTO unit enables combined ploughing work to be carried out with implements fitted at the front and rear of the tractor, thus reducing the number of passes necessary, the working hours, and ground compaction. Here is the 90 horsepower robotic system at work on wheat stubble with a 7-tine chisel plough at the front and a rear-mounted rotary hoe. Depth of work reaches 25 centimeters, and with a single pass, the ground is ready for sowing. Even traditional ploughing work is completely reformed by the robotic system. With one plough at the front and another at the rear, thereby substantially improving weight distribution and thus ground holding, our tractors from 90 horsepower can easily till firm ground with a total of 5 ploughshares, drastically reducing working time. From the economic point of view, a Same tractor allows considerable savings to be made during heavy cultivation work. In the first place, let us consider the saving in energy. Dealing with ploughing, where the tractor works continuously at maximum power, the fuel consumption represents a heading of prime importance within the operating costs. From the official approval tests, specific consumption figures for our tractors of less than 170 grams per horsepower hour have been recorded, with a minimum record point of only 150 grams per horsepower hour. If we compare the consumption of our tractors at full power with the average recorded by the official data of our competitors, 185 grams per horsepower hour, on an annual usage basis of 1,000 hours at maximum output, we find a substantial fuel saving, which in the case of the higher power tractor, 165 horsepower, amounts to 4,600 litres, equal to 575 pounds. Furthermore, the ease of manoeuvrability, the greater ground holding of our tractors, allied to the high efficiency of their dual traction and the remarkable performance of the Same automatic control unit, enable us to make a realistic estimate of a time saving of 10%. Which, on the annual basis of 1,000 hours, means a substantial saving of 100 hours. Translated into money, these 100 hours would save, again on a 165 horsepower tractor, labour costs of about £600 and 3,700 litres of fuel, equal to about £462, which, added to the fuel savings over the 900 working hours, comes out at £1,000. To do the heavy ploughing with our high-power tractor would enable you to achieve an overall saving of some £1,600.